Today on Versus, it's a battle of H. John Benjamins. In this corner, defending burger flipping, Whitney Van Lanningham. And in this corner, fighting on the internet, just like the old gypsy woman said, Chris Carr.
Can you really compare these two shows?
Yeah, dude, H. John Benjamin is amazing in literally everything he does.
Contractually, you're required.
You're not my supervisor.
Shut up and fight! Two shows enter, one show leaves. Hit like, punch subscribe, it's time for Versus! Theme song!
Archer's jazzy opening with a roaring horn section wipes the floor with Bob's Burgers' ukulele and duck quacks. Bob's Burgers opening sounds like one of Jimmy Fallon's children's instrument segments. The Archer opening is like if a James Bond opening had a baby with the one from Cowboy Bebop. On! How can you top that? Archer also features another jazz number for its closing, The Killer. It's got this sort of old Johnny Quest vibe, and I really dig it. You hear that song, and you're juiced for another episode. You're ready to binge, just like Archer. Plus, later in the series, we get all those great Sherilyn songs. Now, despite being a Southerner, I'm actually not a huge fan of country music, but hot damn, could Sherilyn bring it! I love listening to those twangy tunes as the gang protected their piles of Colombian snow.
Yeah, okay, cool. Have a blast in your lame-ass jazz club. The Belchers and I will be here, chilling with our ukuleles and fun. The Bob's Burger opening might be one of my top five favorites of all time. It really sets the stage for the story of a hardworking family that sticks together and makes it work despite everything stacked against them. Burger joint catches on fire? Grand reopening! Rat infestation? Grand re-reopening! Telephone pole crushes their home and place of employment? Grand re-re-reopening! The Bob's Burgers intro is all about perseverance and family and love. The Archer intro is about murdering people and banging hot chicks, which, whatever, I guess is kind of cool. But not as cool as a family who loves cheeseburgers and each other! Plus, I love that they did their own version of the couch gag by subbing out the exterminator trucks and the business on the right of the burger joint.
Plot!
The incredible thing about Archer is its ability to adapt and change. The first few seasons were set in a Cold War-era-esque ambiguous time, with the main thrust of the show focusing on the antics of the spy organization ISIS.
Ooh, whoops.
That name definitely needed to be changed. Is that how so many dumb Americans got recruited? That thought they'd get to have Bloody Marys with Archer and watch Gator? Creator Adam Reed then took the gang out of the spy biz and explored other options for them, like dealing cocaine, working for the CIA, and being PIs in Los Angeles. Reed has turned Archer into more like an anthology, like American Horror Story, except it's something I can actually stomach since I'm such a huge wuss. Archer now explores new concepts and settings that the cast can go nuts in, like the show's eighth season, Archer Dreamland. That's all on Sterling Subconscious and puts the cast in a gangland-era noir-style film set in Los Angeles in the 1940s. Season 9, Archer Danger Island, re-envisions the characters as inhabitants from a tiny island in the South Pacific in the 1930s. Supposedly what we're getting for season 10 is a new setting. Space, baby! With a 1970s Stanley Kubrick alien vibe, I'm really hoping. What you always get from the show, despite any location swaps, time jumps, or selling of blow, is rapid-fire dialogue, pop culture reference heavy humor, and tons of meta jokes. A family sitcom like Bob's Burgers is sweet and all, but isn't that like almost every other show out there? Archer is a one-of-a-kind, boo-soaked joyride that spans genres. But I guess your burger puns are cute.
Bob's Burger puns are cute! The cauliflower is cumin from inside the house? The Gordon Hamsay burger? Poutine on the Ritz? Poblano Picasso? Come on! Those are genius! Archer is a glorified drunk baby man-child. He's barely functioning. He wouldn't be able to come up with these puns if he tried. His brain is already pickling from all the gummy bears and scotch. Bob's Burgers actually takes the cartoon family sitcom model and elevates it. Forget Family Guy and The Simpsons. Those shows just rely on pop culture and celebrity guests instead of focusing on the family and their real-life issues. The Belchers make you feel normal and not normal all at the same time, and that's okay! The plot follows Bob, Linda, and their three kids as they try to run a successful burger restaurant in either South Jersey or Long Island or one of those places. It really paints a picture of what it's like to grow up in a wacky family business where every single member of the family is involved, and what it's like to work as hard as you can and still just be scraping by. Plus, the life lessons on that show are incomparable. Bob's Burgers has themes of gender identity, sexuality, and even tells you what to do if you poop your pants in a sexy dance fighting class. There's also a lot of butts on this show. Like, a lot of butts. And Tina's gonna touch every one of them!
Characters!
Obviously, at the top of the cast, we have Sterling Archer, codenamed Duchess. This womanizing booze hound works with his domineering mom, Mallory, his on-again, off-again, on-again girlfriend, Lana, with her man hands, her ex, accountant-turned-spy, Cyril Figgis, HR head, Pam Poovey, who loves fight clubs and drugs, Secretary Cheryl Tunt, who sniffs glue, likes a good strong choke, and ends up being a railroad heiress. We also have Gillette, the gay voice of reason on the show who's given robo legs that sometimes work. And Krieger, a crazy scientist who might just be an Adolf Hitler clone and has a holographic anime wife. The voice casting is what really makes the show. H. John Benjamin is brilliant as Archer. Jessica Walter is the only choice for Mallory. Aisha Tyler, Chris Parnell, Amber Nash, Judy Greer, Lucky Yates, these guys all crush their parts. Plus, on top of an already all-star cast, you get crazy awesome guest stars like Jeffrey Tambor, Christian Slater, Keegan-Michael Key, Bryan Cranston, J.K. Simmons. Sometimes they even show up just to play themselves, like Burt Reynolds and Alton Brown and Anthony Bourdain and Kenny Loggins. K-Logs was one of my favorites. Oh, it was just so goddamn weird. So it's cute and all when a comedian shows up on Bob's Burgers to play a kid, but it's no Danger Zone sequence.
How can you defend the characters on Archer? They're all 100% unlikable. Not a single one of them is even remotely a good person. The cast of Archer is full of terrible people. They're always sleeping with each other and killing guys and inventing sex robots and doing cocaine. Bob's Burgers has much funnier, much more likable characters. Bob would never treat Linda the way that Archer treats Lana, or Woodhouse. Bob is basically just a dad who loves cheeseburgers and puns and hanging out with his wife and kids. He makes mistakes all the time, but that's because he's just a big, impulsive kid at heart. He's the perfect dad and always makes time to hang out with his kids individually. As a parent, he's completely accepting and understanding of all of his kids' weird behavior, and he loves Linda more than anything. And who wouldn't? Linda is constantly making up hilarious songs, and she's exactly who I want to be when I grow up. Plus, she's voiced by John Roberts. He manages to put on the perfect South Jersey Long Island mom accent, and I am living for it. And look at their amazing kids. Tina is the perfect role model for any young girl discovering her sexuality. The show handles her growing and maturing in a really cool, non-judgmental way, and I love how open and honest this show is about that. And sure, it's lame that she loves horses, but what she lacks in cool points, she makes up for in dance moves and butt touching. And that's what really counts. Dan Mintz does the best possible job voicing a teen girl. The sounds he makes alone are pure gold. And then there's Gene, who's totally gender fluid. He's constantly making totally gender ambiguous jokes, and I think it's really important for kids and adults alike to see that it's okay to be yourself and to embrace the qualities that make you unique. Of course, then there's Louise, and she's just amazing. She's my favorite character. She's this little tiny bunny rabbit full of hatred and revenge, but she's also really amazing and loves her family more than anything, especially her dad and brother. Plus, she's voiced by Kristen Schaal. She's worth more than half the voice actors in Archer combined. I don't know, man. Archer's a cool show, but Bob's actually teaches you not to be a horrible human being.
Whatever, I guess I do love cheeseburgers.
And you know I've always wanted to be an international super spy.
Oh, this is my least favorite part. I just want you to hate each other.
But it's really hard, Scott. Chris is so cool.
You both suck. Cast your votes now. Loser will be forced to suck pudding through their nose with a straw.
That could actually be tasty.
The pudding will be full of bugs.
Gross! Ew! Why?